Amen. Nobody's got a song. Amen. Y'all feel funny if I said I ain't got a message. Amen. Amen. Some of y'all need to learn how to sing. Amen. 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 Acts chapter number 9. Amen. Amen. I'm guessing y'all got me up here early. Amen. So you mean that must mean you want me to preach long. Amen. Amen. I got bad news. Amen. Amen. That might not work. Amen. Amen. It might work. Amen. 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 Acts chapter number 9. Amen. I'm going to give you a thought this morning that I hope will help you. I'll tell you, this scripture, I hope it's familiar to you. If it's not, I hope it is by the end of this service today. Amen. But here in Acts chapter number 9, I was studying one thing this week. I'll kind of tell you this before we get into this. I was studying one thing. And I don't know if any of you teachers are like this. You study one thing and God opens your eyes to something else. Amen. You kind of see something else in there and you think, well, I guess I'll go with that. Amen. So here in Acts chapter number 9, I'm going to ask you to stand when you get turned. I'm going to read two verses of scripture. Kind of do this a little different, you might say it's a little funny, but Acts chapter number 9, I'm going to read verse 10 and then I'm going to read verse 17. Acts chapter number 9, verse number 10. It says, and there was a certain disciple at Damascus named Ananias. And to him said the Lord in a vision, Ananias, and he said, behold, I am here, Lord. And verse 17 said, and Ananias went his way and entered into the house and putting his hands on him said, Brother Saul, the Lord, even Jesus, that appeared unto thee in the way as thou camest, has sent me that thou mightest receive thy sight and be filled with the Holy Ghost. So let us pray. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to stand this morning. We thank you for your grace and your saving grace. Lord, we pray that you'd remove anything from the midst that would hinder us from preaching to your glory this morning, dear Lord. I need your help this morning. I need you to come down and get all over me this morning. I need you, dear Lord. I pray that you would help your people in this message, dear Lord. I pray that you just uplift your son in this. In Jesus' name, and amen. Amen. You can be seated. Amen. You can be seated. Here, Acts chapter number 9, I want to tell you a little bit what it's about. If you don't know, amen, we all associate Acts chapter number 9. Now, brother, we're going to have to be quiet back there. Amen. Or we ain't going to be able to preach. Amen. 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 It's me or you. Amen. 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 Acts chapter number 9. Amen. What happened here? You know this story. This is the story where Apostle Paul comes on the scene. Amen. He's been on the scene for a little while here, but Saul has been on the scene for a little while. And this chapter is when Paul comes on the scene. Amen. Same person. Amen. But he's changed. Amen. Same person, but he's changed. Amen. You know, that's how it ought to be with salvation. I'll just give you a little thought. Amen. How it ought to be with salvation. You're the same person, but you changed. Amen. Amen. Things ought not be the same after salvation. Amen. Amen. But here in Acts chapter 9, we know that this story, if you've studied it any, you know this is about the conversion of Saul. Amen. This is about when Saul comes down the road and we know that he's blinded. And we're going to look at some of these things here. But it's easy to overlook a different person in this scripture, and that's Ananias. Amen. I want to look at Ananias for a minute this morning and give you a thought. My thought I want to take out of verse 17. And like I said, this might not be a long one this morning. Amen. But we'll beat the Methodists to the steakhouse. Amen. We'll be so happy. I think, golly, what happened to them? Amen. 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 But I say that and then we'll be here all day. Amen. Amen. But verse 17, I was intrigued by this verse. It says, and Ananias went his way. And I want to preach on that little thought this morning on Ananias went his way. Amen. In this scripture, where we've all, if you're saved this morning, you've all been Saul. Amen. Amen. Don't die on me yet. Amen. Amen. If you're saved, you've all been in the shoes of Saul here in this scripture. Amen. If you're saved, you had to have some type of experience where the Lord came to you and showed you that you were lost. Amen. And needed salvation. Amen. Amen. You had to have some type of experience like that. And I want to say, if you're saved, you're all going to be Ananias at some point. Amen. You're going to be Ananias at some point. Amen. I want you to know what God had Ananias do here is a big thing, amen. But and we look at this and we think, praise God that Ananias followed the Lord and Ananias did what God had him to do, amen. But friend, in your life and in my life, God's going to come to you the same way. Amen. He's going to come to you the same way. Amen. So I want to look, and if you'll just be with me for just a few minutes here, I want to look on Ananias went his way. That's a peculiar way to say it. We read that scripture. If you take that out of context, you'll say, well, Ananias went his way. He went off on his own path. Amen. If you take it out of context, amen, like we sometimes do with scripture, amen. But here, you find out that Ananias went into, you read up in verse 11, and I'm getting ahead of myself. We'll get to this in a minute, amen. But it said, Jesus told him, or the Lord told him, he said, inquire in the house of Judas. Amen. Ananias went his way, and it wasn't the way that he would normally go. Get that. Get that, amen. Get that this morning, amen. Just by way of introduction, I want to tell you, each of you and each of, and myself included, we've all got a way that God wants us to go. Amen. We've all got something to do, amen. God didn't save you to warm up a church pew. No, friend, God didn't save you to sit around like a knot on a log throughout the week. Amen. Amen. God didn't save you to be quiet throughout the week. Amen. 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 God didn't save you to be quiet in church. Amen. Amen. But I want you to know, friend, we've all got something to do. Amen. And here Ananias, it says, Ananias went his way. Amen. Went his way. Amen. Wednesday night, we preached a little on, we've been studying over there in Galatians. I say preach because I go in it with the intention of teaching and end up preaching. Amen. That's just how it goes. Amen. But we've been looking over there in Galatians and Apostle Paul, he was kind of, validating his ministry to him, kind of telling him about his ministry. And he says over there in that first chapter, he said, I didn't go to the apostles. He said, I didn't go ask the apostles. That was 3 years. He said, I went after 3 years and talked to Peter for 15 days. Amen. He said, I didn't go to the apostles. Amen. When God called me, amen, when God brought me, amen, I went the way God had me go. Amen. Now here in this scripture, you're going to see it says Ananias went his way. Amen. My friend, Ananias' way was not William's way.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I want you to notice that. Amen. Amen. And my way might not be your way. It might not be the way that God has you to witness. And God has you. Friend, I want you to know. Amen. I've said this many times in this pulpit, and I'll say it till God tells me to quit saying it. Not everybody's a preacher. Amen. Not everybody's a teacher. Not everybody's a singer. Not everybody is is the one that's going to sit there and shout the house down.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If God puts it on you, do it. Amen. I believe if God puts it on you, you ought to do it. Amen. Amen. But I want you to know God doesn't have everybody doing the same thing. Amen. And here Ananias, we see in this scripture, I want to look at Ananias' way just for a minute this morning and look at a few things about Ananias' way. First, I want you to look in verse number 3 of this chapter. I'm going to be all over this chapter, so keep your Bible open. Amen. But verse number 3, it said, and this is talking about Saul. Amen. Well, let's read from verse 1. It said, and Saul yet breathing out threatenings and slaughter against the disciples of the Lord went unto the high priest and desired of him letters to Damascus to the synagogues, that if he found any of this way, whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound unto Jerusalem. Say, preacher, what's going on here? Amen. Saul's coming in. He's breathing out threatenings and slaughter. Amen. Amen. I'm not, say, preacher, I wish you'd say that a little bit nicer. Amen. But I want you to know he was coming in to kill the Christians. Amen. He was coming in to kill the Christians. Amen. Apostle Paul, amen. Boy, you ain't going to like this. Amen. It'll be all right, though. Apostle Paul was a terrorist.
Amen.
Just let that sink in for a minute. Amen. Apostle Paul was a terrorist. Amen. Amen. While he was led by religious instruction. Amen. The Bible says he was religious. Amen. Why, if in today's day and age, if we want to put Apostle Paul, or let me rephrase, if we want to put Saul at this state, in this day and age, we'd put group him in with ISIS probably. Amen. 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 We'd say there's no hope for them. Amen. Amen. And when they die, he's out here killing everybody, amen, and killing those we love, and we've seen that in our country today. We've seen terror groups doing that today, and we'll be the mossy back Christians saying, well, they deserve hell.
Amen.
Amen. Am I not right about that? Amen. I know it ain't going to go over good. Amen. Because it's right. It's the truth. Amen. It's how we are. Amen. Amen. Why we'll get on our high horse and say, you know what? They deserve the lowest pit of hell. Amen. And not realizing that you deserve the lowest pit of hell and I deserve the lowest pit of hell. Well, Brother Eddie, this morning, he done touched on it. You break one of them commandments, you're guilty of all of them. Amen. I'm just with them. Amen. You're just with them. Amen. Saul here. Amen. If he'd been in this day and age, amen, we would have been sitting on our high horse saying he deserves hell. Amen. 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 But here, thank God that God doesn't look like we do. Doesn't think like we do. Amen. Doesn't see people like we do. Amen. Amen. But here, look at verse 3. He said, and as he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly there shined around about him a light from heaven, and he fell to the earth and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, who art thou, Lord? Amen. And the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. And he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? And the Lord said unto him, arise and go into the city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. I want you to see number one. Amen. And now notice this. Now notice this. Ananias' way, it was a prepared way. Amen. It was a prepared way. I'm going to take your suit coat off. Amen. Somebody said, Lord, have mercy. We're going to be here a while. Amen. 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 I'm getting warm up here. Amen. 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 But Ananias' way, amen, it was a prepared way. Amen. Notice this. Notice in the scripture we've already read this morning. Amen. And down to verse number 6. Amen. Ananias ain't mentioned yet. Yeah. Amen. Ananias is not mentioned here yet. We don't know about Ananias. Now, I heard somebody say this once, and I want to tell them, you got to read your Bible. You can't possibly be that dumb. Amen. They said, this is the same Ananias that Ananias and Sapphira. Amen. Well, they died in chapter number 5. If it's the same one, something's wrong. Amen. Amen. My Bible's confusing. Amen. Amen. So this is the first time we hear about Ananias here in Damascus. Amen. It's the first time we hear about him. Amen. But here, amen, he hasn't been mentioned yet. But here comes God on the scene to to Saul. Amen. Not Apostle Paul yet. Amen. He comes on the scene and he prepares the way. Amen. He prepares the way. Amen. Before verse number 10 comes along, amen, God comes in and prepares the way. Amen. Ain't you glad this morning that your God, amen, is a preparing God? Amen. Is a preparing God. Amen. Amen. My friend, amen, he does all the work before you get there. Amen. He does all the work before you get there, friend. I've noticed this. Amen. Before verse number 10, God was working. Amen. Amen. Before God said Ananias, he was working. He was working. He was preparing. Amen. He was preparing. Amen. You know, there's times in my life, there's times in your life, friend, I'm getting ahead of myself this morning. Amen. But it's just how it's going to go. Amen. There's times in my life where God will come to me and ask me to do something, and I'll say, I can't. I can't. Amen. Knowing good and well, I can. But I'll say, I can't. Amen. Why? Because we're lazy. Amen. I'm just going to get right down and honest with you this morning. Amen. We're lazy. Amen. It inconveniences us. Amen. We're the most convenient people in the world. We got to have everything just the way we want it. Amen. It's got to be great. It's got to be perfect. Why? We've even got it on video camera here for those that can't make it. Amen. Amen. That's pitiful. Amen. I'm going to say that's pitiful. Amen. That's pitiful. Amen. That we've got to be so convenienced. Amen. But here, when God comes and says, hey, I want you to do something, we'll say, well, it's really going to be hard to do that right now. Amen. I don't know if I can do that yet. Amen. Amen. Well, I don't know if the time is right. Amen. Amen. Well, I don't know if the time is right. Amen. Well, I say, preacher, I'm just waiting on the Lord. Amen. Amen. Now, friend, you can't wait on the Lord after the Lord's come to you and told you to do it. Amen. Amen. Then you've done missed him. Amen. That's what the point is. Amen. 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 Don't miss the Lord while you're trying to wait on the Lord. Amen. 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 If God comes to you with something to do, amen, you best believe he's already prepared the way for you. Amen. Amen. I want you to know, amen, I've been preaching for about 3.5 years now. And I remember when God dealt with me about preaching, God was dealing with me. One of the biggest fears I had, you say, preacher, this is foolish. This is crazy. This is honest. This is honesty. What come in my mind is I thought there'll be two or three preachers that might want me to come to their church and preach, and nobody else is going to want me. I said, ain't nobody going to believe that I'm preaching. Ain't nobody going to want me to. Nobody's going to have me in their pulpit. Amen. I'm not going to be able to do anything. It's going to fizzle out. Amen. Amen. You know, a lot of times we get like that when God calls us to something. We'll say, God, I can't do it because it's going to fizzle out.
Amen.
Amen. I can't do it because it's going to fizzle out. Amen. It wasn't long after I announced my call to preach, I was getting calls left and right. I ain't saying this to boast in myself. I'm saying this to boast in God. Amen. God had already prepared the way. Amen. He had already prepared an opening there, an opening at different places. Amen. Amen. He prepared that way. Amen. God knew what he was doing before I ever accepted that call. Amen. Amen. I want you to know, friend, when God comes to you about doing something for him, amen, he's already got it prepared. Amen. He's not waiting on you to get it all together. Amen. Notice that. Notice that in this scripture. You'll find out. Amen. Amen. God didn't call. I want you to notice this now. I want you to get this. Put a good grip on this for me here. God did not call Ananias to save Paul. Amen. God did not call Ananias to save Paul. Amen. I believe in this scripture. I believe this is a very literal picture of somebody leading somebody to Christ. Amen. Amen. And God did call him to lead him to Christ. Amen. To tell him what needs to be done. Amen. Amen. And can I tell you today, in this day and age, you ain't going to save nobody. Amen. I ain't going to save nobody. Amen. But you can lead somebody to Christ. Amen. Amen. Say, preacher, well, I can't do nothing. I can't do anything. You can lead somebody to God. Amen. I promise you that. Amen. I promise you that. Amen. Why? Because God prepares the way. Amen. God will never call you to something that isn't ready. Amen. God will never call you to something that isn't ready. Amen. Amen. There's been times. Amen. Amen. Think about this. Think about this. When God laid this message on my heart this week, I was studying something else. I was studying something else. God laid this message on my heart, showed me some things that I'd never seen this before. I never looked at it this way before. And God laid this on my heart. He knew who was going to be here this morning.
Amen.
Amen. He knew exactly who was going to be here. Amen. Now, wouldn't it be easy? Wouldn't it be easy? Amen. I'm going to get right down in our tater roll. Amen. But wouldn't it be easy for me to get here and say, me to think all week, you know, that would be good for so-and-so. And then I get here on Sunday and so-and-so ain't here. Amen. Well, I better figure out something else to preach. You know, there's a lot of preachers that do that, and I don't like that. Amen. If God gives it to you, if it's from God, amen, God prepares the way. God don't expect you to prepare the way for the message, amen. God will give you the message, amen, and he'll prepare the way for it, amen. God came to Ananias here, but he had already been working behind the scenes. Amen. He'd already been working for it. Well, it's just like over there. We preached a while back on Abraham and kind of the similar situation. Amen. God came to Abraham, called on him. Amen. And Abraham had the same response that Ananias had in verse number 10. He said, here I am. He said, I'm here. Amen. Amen. When God came to Abraham and told him to go sacrifice Isaac, amen, God already had the sacrifice prepared up there at the top. Amen. 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 We look in that scripture, you can see how Abraham was focused on doing God's business. Amen. And God was taking care of his business behind him. Amen. Amen. Friend, that's how you ought to be this morning. Amen. You ought to get so focused on doing God's business and let God take care of your business. Amen. 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 We see in this, amen, the Ananias, amen, I want you to know his way. Amen. It was a prepared way. God had already set things up. Now notice this. Look at verse 10. It said, and there was a certain disciple at Damascus named Ananias. To him said the Lord in a vision, Ananias. And he said, behold, I am here, Lord. In verse 11, notice this. This is important. This is an important part of the scripture here. Verse 11 said, and the Lord said unto him, arise and go into the street which is called Straight, and inquire in the house of Judas for one called Saul of Tarsus, for behold, he prayeth, and hath seen in a vision a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him, that he might receive his sight. Amen. 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 Notice that not only was Ananias' way this morning, it was an prepared way, but it was an instructed way. Amen. He didn't leave him on a limb out there hanging. Amen. Amen. Some of y'all ain't going to get this. Amen. He didn't leave him left out in the open. Saying, here, you're my servant. What it said here in verse 10, it said it was a certain disciple. Certain disciple. Verse 9, verse 1, it said, and Saul yet breathing out threatenings and slaughter against the disciples. Amen. 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 Here, verse 10, we find a disciple. Amen. And God comes to him and tells him, hey, there's something I need you to do. But he doesn't just say, hey, go do something. Amen. He doesn't just say, hey, go figure it out on your own. Amen. Go figure it out. Amen. Amen. You know, too often we think God's like that. That's why we won't do anything. We've got no faith whatsoever. Amen. Amen. Say, preacher, I've got all kinds of faith. Well, Bible says faith without works is dead. Amen. That means your faith will manifest itself through works. Amen. That means if you ain't doing anything, it's going to be hard for me or a lost person, amen, to believe you've got faith. Amen. 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 But I want you to know, friend, amen, we don't have faith, amen, because when God tells us to do something, we think, well, I won't know what to do. Amen. You know, I've studied this Bible. I'm not boasting in myself, but I've studied the Bible a lot. Amen. I've never found God just leave somebody hanging. Amen. Have you? Amen. When God told Noah to build an ark, amen, he didn't leave him hanging. He didn't just say, hey, build an ark. Ain't nobody ever seen a boat before because they ain't never needed one before. So you just build one. Figure it out. Figure it out on your own. Amen. You know, I got thinking about this earlier in the week. If Noah had built that ark the way that he wanted to, nobody had ever seen a boat before. Amen. Nobody had ever seen that. Amen. If Noah had done that the way that he wanted to, amen, it wouldn't have lasted. Amen. It would have sunk. Amen. Amen. That's just like in your life. Amen. If you always do everything you want to do, amen. Amen. You can be in God's work. Amen. Don't you get me wrong. You can be in God's work. Amen. And doing it the way you want to do it. Amen. It won't work. Amen. Amen. It won't work. Why? Too often. Amen. Too often. Amen. We get into my text this morning was verse 17. Ananias went his way. Well, we get too often and I want to tell Dale how to do his way. Amen. I need to tell Carolyn how to do her way. Amen. Nuh-uh. That ain't how that works. Amen. You leave that to God. Amen. Amen. You leave that to God. Amen. I want to tell you, when God was dealing with me about preaching, amen, and called me to preach, I want you to know, friend, I sat under some good preachers. Amen. I had a few. I grew up in church all my life. It was inevitable. Somebody was going to say something to me about it. Amen. Amen. My family, my papa was a preacher. Amen. My uncle's a great preacher. Amen. Amen. I had them come to me. Oh, you going to be a preacher. You going to be a preacher. Amen. They had done that all my life when I was little. Amen. And I'd shrug it off and say, no. No, no, amen, because guess what? They couldn't call me to preach. Amen. They couldn't call me to preach. Amen. Amen. And I ain't saying that they were trying to, lead my life. No, they were just probably just joking around with me. Amen. But I want you to know, friend, when God came down and God said, this is what I want you to do, that's when I had to do it.
Amen.
Amen. That's when I had to do it. Amen. Amen. Don't you let somebody else tell you what to do for the Lord. Amen. If God ain't strong enough to put it on your heart, then you don't need to do it. Amen. If God ain't big enough to lay it on your heart to do, amen, amen, then it ain't going to be done. Amen. It need not be done. Amen. I've seen that before. God, he'll come straight to somebody. Amen. He'll come straight to somebody. Amen. 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 Notice this. Amen. It was an instructed way. God wasn't secretive about what to do. Amen. God ain't going to be secretive in your life about what to do. When God calls you into something, amen, we'll sit around all the time. Amen. Say, preacher, how do you know? Because I've done it. Amen. We'll sit around and say, I don't know what to do. Oh, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. Amen. I've been preaching for 3.5 years here. Ain't a long time. Ain't a long time. But sometimes I'll sit around and say, I just don't know what to do. I don't know how to preach. Amen. I don't know what to say. I don't know what, how to get up there, amen. And I thank God that, I really don't know how to preach, amen. Amen. I thank God that God knows how to use me to be a vessel for Him and preach for Him, amen. Amen. But, friend, we'll get in that. Sometimes we'll say, God, I don't know what to do.
Amen.
And isn't it easy? Well, look, and I tell you, we're here in the Bible Belt. Amen. We got so much good preaching around this area. Amen. You just look around. Amen. But it's so easy. I go sit under another preacher and say, well, I guess I better do it like him. Amen. Amen. We get like that sometimes. We get like that. Well, I guess we got to do it like them. Well, this is what they're doing with this, so we better do it like that. Amen. We'll get like that. We'll get like that. That's wrong. Amen. That might sound good, but that's wrong. Amen. 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 God won't leave you in secret about what to do. Amen. He'll give you instruction. Amen. The Bible says over, I wrote this down in Proverbs chapter number 4 and verse 13, take fast hold of instruction. Let her not go. Keep her, for she is thy life. Amen. Amen. That means we need to get in the, say, preacher, I don't have any instruction. Well, have you spent any time with God?
Amen.
With His instruction? Amen. You ain't going to find, it's just kind of, this is crazy. Amen. It's kind of like calling me on the phone. Amen. You are never going to get a hold of me if you don't call me.
Amen.
Amen. You ain't never going to get a hold of me if you don't call me. Amen. If you dial in the wrong number, amen, you ain't never going, I'm never going to answer the phone because that phone ain't never going to ring.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Friend, I want you to know it's the same way with God. Amen. And if you sit around and said, well, I can't never talk to William. Amen. I can't never talk to him. And say, well, what number are you dialing? This number? Well, that's the wrong number. Amen. That's why you can't never get a hold of him. Amen. 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 But I got a little friend down in Cookville. And I'll tell you a story. I changed my number when I left college. Amen. When I graduated from college, I ended up getting a new phone, got a new number and everything. And he had my old number. And I went down there once, and he said, you don't never answer the phone. Amen. And I said, what are you talking about, Arlie? And he said, I've been calling. Look, this is the number I've been calling. I said, well, that's the wrong number. Amen. No wonder you don't get me. He's plumb mad at me. Amen. 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 He calls me every Wednesday now. Amen. 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 I have to call him back or if I get in trouble if I forget. Amen. Amen. That's side of the point. Amen. But I want you to know, friend. Amen. You know, if you can sit around and complain that God ain't told me what to do, I can't get a hold of God. Amen. I can't get in contact with him. Amen. But you ain't never called him. Amen. You ain't never looked for an answer, amen. You ain't never figured it out, amen. You ain't never tried, amen. Don't you sit around and complain that you can't get a hold of God. Amen. Amen, my friend. Amen. You gotta get in the spirit of talking to Him. Amen. You gotta get in the spirit of calling on Him. Amen. Amen. Take fast hold of instruction. Amen. That's what the Bible says. That means you gotta get a grip on what God tells you to do. Not on what God tells you, your friends to do. Amen. On what God tells you to do. Amen. Amen. Just because God calls me to do it, amen, doesn't mean you have to.
Amen.
Amen. Just because God calls you to do it doesn't mean I have to. Amen. It does mean you ought to pray for me in it, and I ought to pray for you in it. Amen. It doesn't mean I do it for you, and it doesn't mean you do it for me. Amen. It means we lift up one another. Amen. 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 The Bible says over in Galatians chapter 6 about bearing one another's burdens. Amen. You which are strong. Amen. You which are strong. Amen. Hey, you know, there's times, amen, when we get weak.
Amen.
Amen. There's times when we get weak. Amen. That's what we're here for. We need to lift each other up. Amen. But I can't walk your path. Amen. I can't walk your path and you can't walk my path. Amen. Amen. The Bible says, well, work out your own salvation with meekness and trembling. Amen. You know what that means? Amen. You know what, or fear and trembling. You know what that means? That means when God calls you into something, friend, and God says, I want you to do this, you can't grab somebody else and say, here, God wants us to do this. Amen. Amen. I've had too many tell me, amen. I'm just going to get real down and personal. I've had too many tell me what to do about what God's given me. Amen. Well, this is what you ought to do. Say, preacher, you oughtn't to go here. Amen. I'm going to anyway. Amen. I'm going to poke it anyway. Amen. 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 They'll say, well, if I was you. Boy, when somebody starts saying, well, if I was you, you might not start running. Amen. Amen. I understand in everyday life, amen, you can get some advice from people, amen. But if it's in the work of God and they say, well, if I was you, If I was you, amen, you turn and run the other way, amen. 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 You turn and run to God's word, amen. Say, God, hey God, what am I supposed to do, amen. Amen. God will give you instructions, amen. Amen. Now notice this, amen, I'm taking too long, amen. It's a prepared way, an instructed way. No, notice this, but verse number 13, it gets really real. It gets really real here. It says, then Ananias answered, Lord, I have heard by many of this man how much evil he hath done to thy saints at Jerusalem, and here he hath authority. Notice this. Notice this. He says he hath authority from the chief priests to bind all that call on thy name. Amen. Amen. Boy, ain't you glad? Amen. I'll get into this in a second. Ain't you glad that when the world gives Satan authority, he still has to go through God? Amen. Ain't you glad of that? Amen. When it said, notice this, Ananias, he had a real claim here. He said, here he has authority from the chief priests. He said, here he has authority from the head honchos over here. Amen. Amen. He has authority from those that are in charge to come in here and kill us. Amen. He has authority from them. Amen. Amen. But friend, I want you to know, I could just hear, friend, I'm not God. Amen. But if I was him, that's what I'd say. I'd say, don't you know, amen, that he don't have the authority from me. Amen. He don't have the authority from me. Amen. Hey, friend, when everybody else is saying, everybody else is bowing down, amen, I was studying, amen, I preached tonight on those three Hebrew children back there in the book of Daniel, amen. But when everybody else is bowing down, amen, and everybody else is quit, amen, amen, because the authority is given to Satan and the powers of this world, amen. And if you look around, amen, you won't have to look far. You'll find, amen, Satan has all kinds of authority in this world, amen, amen. But anything, hey, friend, with you, amen, he has to go through God, amen, amen. He doesn't have authority from God to do anything. Amen. 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 I want you to know, amen. Brother Eddie, he mentioned it this morning. He's mentioned it a few times, talking about Job, amen, when Satan was walking about. Satan can walk about all he wants to. Amen. But he didn't have any authority to do anything. Amen. Amen. To do anything. Amen. Amen. I tell you, I've got the same mindset that Brother Eddie's got. I'm tired of giving Satan so much credit. Amen. He can't do anything. Amen. He can't bother me. Amen. Amen. Now, he's going to. Don't you get me wrong. He's going to come knocking on your door and trying to tempt you. Amen. Hey, friend, but if I stand behind God, amen, he can't do anything. Amen. He can't touch me. Amen. Amen. I'm getting ahead of myself in this. Amen. But we notice, look at this. Look at this. Ananias, he comes to the Lord. He says, Lord, he basically, to sum up verses 13 and 14, he says, if I go to this guy, he's going to kill me. Says, I know it. He's got a proven track record. Amen. It's been proven that this don't work. Amen. That's kind of what he's saying. Amen. He said, it's been proven that those that witnessed to him. Now think about this. If Saul come in here, don't you think, amen, I hope somewhere, amen, I hope somewhere. This is the sad truth of it, amen. They probably wasn't, there might not have been a single Christian that had witnessed to Saul yet, amen. But I hope somewhere along the line, maybe one of these Christians had witnessed to Saul. And then they met their end. Think about that. Think about that. This is a very real thing. They might have came in there and said, Saul, won't you just get saved? Can I tell you the Roman road? Can I tell you this? Amen. Obviously, they didn't have that at this time. Amen. They still had the plan of salvation. Amen. Amen. But they might have said, Saul, won't you do this? And boom, they're dead. Amen. They're dead. Amen. And Ananias looked and said, whoa, I've saw them go into that path before. Amen. I've saw them go down that path before. It didn't end well for my brother over there. Amen. It didn't win well for him. Amen. It didn't end well for them. Amen. I don't know if I can do that, Lord. Amen. Friend, I want you to know Ananias' way, it was a prepared way and it was an instructed way, but friend, it was a frightening way. Amen. Amen. When God comes to you, amen, oh, it's sure easy. It is sure easy. Just sit down for a little while and watch everybody else.
Amen.
Well, I'm glad God's working in so-and-so's life. Well, they're really growing over there at that church. Well, praise God. So-and-so's got so-and-so saved in their family. Amen. That's good. That's good. They're really going out and leading that. They're doing this. They're doing that. Amen. But friend, and that's easy. Well, we can sit back and say, yeah, I'm proud of you, brother. But when God comes down and says, it's your turn. It's your turn. Here, you're up. You're up. You're up. Amen. You're up. Amen. Old friend, we get to looking around. We say, whoa, hey, that wasn't easy. Amen. I see what they did. I didn't, Lord, when I was sitting back admiring their work, amen, I didn't realize I wasn't, they're much capable more of it than I am. Amen. They can do it much better than I could. Amen. Well, I know that I rejoice for them, but I don't want to be there with them. Amen. You know, I'm fine where I'm at. I'm comfortable where I'm at. Amen. Well, it's about high time, friend. Amen. Us as Christians, we got uncomfortable. Amen. Amen. That's the problem. We've gotten too comfortable. Amen. Amen. We need to get a little uncomfortable. Amen. Ananias here, I believe verse 13, I believe he was scared to death. I believe he was very uncomfortable. Amen. I don't believe it was a lack of faith. Don't you get me wrong. Amen. Before you go crucifying him and saying, "Why, golly, he didn't have no faith. The Bible said he was a disciple." Amen. You'd be in the same boat. I'd be in the same boat. Amen. Amen. Let me rephrase that. You've probably been in the same boat. I've been in the same boat. Amen. Saying, "God, I know you give me instruction. I know you've shown me how to do it. You've told me just exactly what to do." Amen. I don't see the end. Amen. But all I can see is the trouble. All I can see is the reasons not to do it. Amen. And if you ain't careful, amen, you'll let all those reasons not to do it overtake God.
Amen.
Overtake God. Amen. 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 Can I tell you this? It ain't always going to be easy and it ain't always going to make sense. Amen. It ain't always going to be easy and it ain't always going to make sense. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thine own understanding. That tells me, that verse right there, that's one of the most quoted verses in the world. And I sometimes think people don't get it. Amen. Because they'll quote that verse and say, "I can see this happening. I can see this and I can see that." Amen. That verse tells me that I can see it, but that doesn't necessarily mean that's how it's going to be. Amen. That verse tells me that just because it makes sense to me, amen, it might not be God's plan. Amen. Amen. There's been things in my life, friend, I've looked at and I've thought, man, I need that right now. Amen. Amen. There's scripture in the Bible. Amen. I have studied and studied and studied and studied and said, "God, I want to preach from this. God, give me a message there." And God said, "No. No." And I thought, man, it's right here in the Word. It can't be wrong. Amen. It can't be wrong. It's in your Word. And God said, "It's wrong right now. The timing's wrong." Amen. It's wrong. It ain't what they need right now. Amen. It ain't what you need right now. Amen. Amen. You know, there's been times, amen. Amen. I don't know if anybody else has been like this. I'll just preach about myself for a minute. There's been times I've read my Bible and I've read my Bible and I've read my Bible and read the same thing and read the same thing and read the same thing. And then finally I read it one time and it just clicks. God says, "There it is. There it is." And I think, "God, why didn't you show me that before?" And then I'll be going through something in my life that I don't understand. And I'll look around and say, "I didn't need it before. I wanted it before, but I didn't need it before."
Amen.
Amen. I didn't need it. I didn't need it then. Amen. But God, you knew what I needed. Amen. You know. Amen. You knew what I needed. Amen. Hey, friend, I want you to know. Amen. It ain't always going to make sense. It's going to be a little scary at times. Amen. It's going to get a little rough at times. Amen. It ain't always, oh, friend, it ain't always going to be happy. Amen. Amen. It ain't always going to be happy. Amen. But friend, it's going to be worth it. Amen. Amen. So we see it's a frightening way. Look at verse 15. Amen. I was getting ahead of myself on this a minute ago. Verse 15, it said, "But the Lord said," amen, there's that "but." Amen. Don't you like that? Amen. That's what that's called when I come to God and say, "God, I can't." And God says, "But you can." Amen. I got to say, "God, here's this." And God says, "But here's this." Amen. I say, "God, here's the world. Here's me. Here's every other circumstance." And God says, "But I'm God." Amen. Don't you like that? Amen. And it says, "But the Lord said unto him, Go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel unto me to bear my name before the Gentiles and kings and the children of Israel. For I will shew him how great things he must suffer for my name's sake." Hey, friend, Ananias makes a good logical argument here, and God says,
Amen.
Go. 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 Why? Why? Because Ananias' way, it was a protected way. It was a protected way. Amen. Ain't you glad for the protection God gives in your life? Amen. Amen. But sometimes, amen, I was thinking of this. Amen. Sometimes you're going to walk. Amen. The Bible says over there, I believe it was David. Psalm 23, verse 4, that, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'll fear no evil, for thou art with me." For thou art with me. Amen. You know, there's some times, amen, where you're going to walk. Amen. You know, we don't get a grasp of that. I've not gotten a grasp of that. I'm going to tell you, I'll be first in the line to tell you I ain't got a grasp of that verse. It's a "yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death." Amen. I've had some hard times here and there, amen, but I've never had to walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I was telling my cousin yesterday, I was talking to him about Brother John Ricketts, amen. I saw him preach a message one time, and he, after Miss Abby, his wife, had cancer diagnosed, and he said, I didn't get it until it came to my house. So you tell everybody all day, I'll pray for you. Yeah, I understand you got cancer, and you. He said, but when that came to my house, then we got serious.
Amen.
Then it made, then I understood it. Amen. Amen. You know, oftentimes, amen, you might need to say, preacher, I don't understand it. Amen. I've not been there yet. Amen. But there'll be some point. Amen. I'm not saying it'll come through cancer. I'm not saying it. Well, I don't know what way it'll come, but there'll be some point where you'll be walking through the valley. Amen. You'll be walking through the shadow of death. Amen. That's where Ananias is at here. Amen. He said, this guy's coming here to kill everybody. Amen. He's coming here to kill the disciples of the Lord. Amen. Verse number one tells us that. Ananias says, hey, I'm a disciple of the Lord, amen, which means he's here to kill me, amen. He said, I'm going to be walking through there, amen, amen. But David, he said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Amen. Amen. Friend, amen, I want you to know, amen, when God calls you to something, amen, He will protect you in that. Amen. He will watch over you in that. Amen. Does that mean it's always going to be easy? No. Amen. Does that mean everybody's always going to love you? No. Amen. Amen. Y'all try preaching. Amen. Amen. Does that mean everybody's always going to agree with you? No.
Amen.
Amen. Does that mean God will always protect you? Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. Amen. Amen. Friend, I want to tell you this morning, amen. You might say, preacher, I'm right there. I'm right there. I'm doing what God's told me to do, and I'm so beaten down. I'm so hurt. It's so difficult, amen. Hey, can I tell you I've been there, amen? Amen. Amen. I've been there in the past week. Amen. Let me tell you, I'll just be honest with you, amen. I've been there, amen. But I want you to know, friend, you get beaten down, you getting realized, amen, God ain't left you yet. You could be dead. You ain't done yet. Amen. God ain't taking you out of here yet. Amen. You've still got work to do. Amen. You're not finished. Amen. Amen. It's a protected way. Amen. Amen. I said this earlier. I'm going to say it again. You take care of God's business, and God will take care of you.
Amen.
Amen. You take care of God's business, and God will take care of you. Amen. Amen. I firmly believe that. I firmly believe that you put God first. Amen. I didn't say take care of your business, and God will take care of you. Sometimes you're going to have to put what you want behind. Sometimes we're going to have to put our business, amen, behind. Amen. Sometimes we're going to have, notice this, this ain't popular preaching, amen, but it's right. Sometimes we're going to have to take a loss. He must increase and I must decrease, what Paul said. Amen. Amen. Sometimes you're going to have to take a loss. Amen. Sometimes it's going to hurt. Amen. Amen. But friend, you take care of God's business. Amen. You take care of God's business. You might lose a couple people. I tell you, I'm not going to sugarcoat it for you. Amen. Amen. I've got a lot of friends now. Let me tell you that much. I got too many to count. Amen. But friend, I had a whole different group of friends before I announced my call to preach. Can I be honest with you? Amen. A lot of those, they dropped like flies. Amen. Not because I went out there and said, hey, I don't like you guys anymore. No. I invited them to church. I'm still inviting them to church. I'm still wanting them to come. I'm still looking for them to come. Amen. And the day they do, hey, I'm going to rejoice. Amen. I'm going to be ready for it. Amen. I'm looking for it. Amen. I left my heart's burden. Amen. But guess what? I've lost a little bit. Amen. But God's taking care of me. Amen. I've not suffered anything. Amen. 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 Friend, you're going to suffer a little bit. Amen. But really, I ain't suffered anything. Amen. Really, you ain't suffered anything. Amen. Amen. While somebody died on the cross for you. Amen. Took the most painful death in the world for you. Amen. Amen. You ain't suffered a thing. Amen. I ain't suffered a thing. Amen. God's provided. Amen. Amen. I want to tell you, friend, God will protect. Amen. He will always protect. Now notice this, last but not least. Amen. Somebody said amen. 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 Here in verse 18. Notice this. This is after verse 17. Amen. Well, let's read 17 with it. Amen. It says, and Ananias went his way. He went his way. He said, and entered into the house. Amen. I'll get back to that in a second. Said, and putting his hands on him, said, Brother Saul, the Lord, even Jesus, that appeared unto thee in the way as thou camest and sent me, that thou mightest receive thy sight and be filled with the Holy Ghost. And immediately. Get that. He wouldn't repeat this prayer after me.
Amen.
We all right? We okay? He wouldn't repeat this prayer. It wouldn't. Now, if you come and do these works, we can see about being saved. No, I said, immediately there fell from his eyes his being scales, and he received sight forthwith and rose and was baptized. When he received me, he was strengthened. Then we saw certain days with the disciples which were at Damascus. And verse 20 says, and straightway he preached Christ in the synagogues that he is the Son of God. Amen. Amen. I want you to know, friend, amen, Ananias' way. We're not going to go back over everything, but I want you to know it was a fruitful way.
Amen.
Amen. The way that God has for you, amen. Amen. It might not. The Bible says, amen, that God's word will not return void. God's word will not return void. Amen. Say, preacher, every time you got up and preached, have the altars been full? No. Not every time. No. There's been times, friend, there's been times that we've had services, we've had them here, shouting the house down. Amen. Amen. The Spirit freely going in. I'd like to have a few more of them. I don't know about you. Amen. Amen. But there's been times it's been dead.
Amen.
Amen. There's been times it's been dead. Amen. There's been times that's over there. I firmly believe that's over there in 2 Timothy chapter number 4 when he says preach in season, out of season. There's in season preaching. Amen. There's out of season preaching. Amen. There's in season when everybody's hungry for it and everybody wants it. Amen. Amen. And there's out of season when sometimes we get our minds on everything else. Amen. Amen. But you still got, that's what Paul was saying to Timothy. You still got to keep preaching at that time. Amen. Don't you just quit because it ain't popular anymore. Amen. Amen. But I want you to say, preacher, what are you saying? I'm saying that there's been, we go out on this visitation. We go out on this visitation. Amen. Say, well, there's going to be some. Amen. I said this when we started it. There's going to be some, they're going to say it's worthless.
Amen.
It's useless. Y'all ain't going to get nobody to come. It ain't going to be worth nothing. Amen. Amen. First week we went out, we got some people to come. Amen. That ain't us, that's God. Amen. But let me tell you, we might not get, there might not be anybody else come in off that visitation. But us taking God's word out, it won't return void. It won't return void. Amen. You know, it could be we go out and knock on a door and they may have never heard of Jesus Christ before. Amen. Say, preacher, I don't believe that everybody. Well, surely everybody's heard of Jesus Christ. Amen. You're lying to yourself. Amen. You're lying to yourself. Amen. Not everybody's heard. Amen. Amen. We need to take it out into these communities and tell them. Amen. We might knock on a door and tell them about the Word of God. Amen. Tell them that God loves them and they might shut the door and slam it in your face. Amen. In 5-6 years down the road. Something comes, something happens in their life, amen, and they remember, hey, I remember when they came by, and they said, God loved me.
Amen.
They might lose everything, they might, I'm not wishing this on anybody, amen, but they might get in a state where they've lost everything, and you remember, he might look at his wife and say, hey, honey, you remember when them people came by and said, hey, God loves us? There might be some truth to that. Amen. I might need to go back to that. Amen. Hey, friend, it could happen 20 years down the road. You might never see the benefits of it. Amen. But can I tell you, going God's way, you doing God's work. Amen. It's a fruitful work. Amen. Amen. There will be some fruit in it. Amen. Amen. Friend, I want you to know, amen, Paul here, amen, when Ananias came to him, amen, it wasn't Ananias, don't get me wrong, it wasn't Ananias that gave him the Holy Ghost. It wasn't that, amen. It wasn't Ananias, amen. Ananias wasn't a miracle worker here, amen. Amen. God was the miracle worker, amen. Ananias just led him to Christ, amen. Amen. And then here, no, I want, you know what, think about this. We don't read any more of this Ananias. I firmly believe that you can say there's different Ananias in the Bible, but I don't think there's any other time in here that we read an account of him. Amen. Paul talks about him, I believe, in Acts 22. But that's about all we don't read an account of what he did any more than this right here. We don't read that. But notice that maybe, you know, you think about him. It says he was a disciple of the Lord, which means he's in heaven. Right? Right, we believe that, right? Amen. You're saved. You're going to heaven. Amen. Amen. Maybe God showed him after he went on and said, "Look, you see today, You see today, 2008, you see July 15th, 2018 down there at Way of the Cross Missionary Baptist Church, there's a preacher preaching. There's a preacher preaching out of that King James Bible. Amen. And half of that Bible he's preaching from was written by that guy. Or half of that New Testament was written by that guy that I told you to go to.
Amen.
That I told you to go to. Well, right there he is over there now. Amen. 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 He might say, hey, look, hey, you, in your lifetime, you might not, it says straightway he preached Christ in the synagogues. Amen. You think about Ananias. Maybe Ananias was like, whoa, amen. He got it. Amen. He might have been a little scared. Amen. We don't know how old Ananias was. He might have died the next day. I don't know. Amen. Amen. But what he did for Christ, amen, what he did for God, not for Ananias, not for Saul, but what he did for God. Amen. What he did for God. Amen. 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 It went on. Amen. It went on. Amen. Hey, there were some things that went on. Amen. Amen. I want you to know, friend. Amen. God can use you. Amen. And God will make your work fruitful. Amen. You might never get a pat on the back. You might never get told good job. Amen. They might never say good message preacher. Amen. Amen. But can I tell you, friend, when that message comes back into their minds late at night. Amen. And God says, hey, that was for you. Amen. Hey, I'm showing this to you. Amen. It'll be fruitful.
Amen.
Amen. It'll be fruitful. Amen. Now, I want to close with this little thought here. I opened with verse 10 and verse 17 for a reason. I did that for a reason this morning. I want you to see this. You see, verse 10, God came by and he said, Ananias. That's all he said. That's all he said. He said, Ananias. Now, draw a little circle around yourself. God, friend, God's going to come by one day. If he ain't done it yet, amen. And if he has done it, he'll be back around again. He's going to say, William. Amen. Amen. Verse 10, I want you to know, verse 10 is inevitable. Verse 10 is coming to you. It's coming to me.
Amen.
Amen. Verse 10's coming. Amen. Amen. There's going to be a time. If you're in God's service, amen. Amen. If you're saved this morning, there's going to be a time when God's going to come knocking and say,
amen,
it's time for you to step up. It's time for you to step up. It's kind of like if you playing baseball or something, you're sitting in the dugout for a while, amen. Amen. It ain't your time to bat, amen. And everybody else is out there doing good. It's all right, amen. But then they're going to come say, hey, you're up. You're up. You're up next. You're up. Amen. Amen. It's going to come. It's inevitable. It's going to happen. Amen. It's going to happen. Amen. He's going to come to you. Verse 17, though, where it says Ananias went his way. Amen. Notice this. I want you to know. Said Ananias went his way and entered into the house. Ananias didn't live in the house of Judas. Notice that. Ananias didn't live in that house. Amen. That's what, because God wouldn't have told him where to go. And God wouldn't have told him where to go. If Ananias was going there anyway, God wouldn't have told him, hey, you need to go here. Think about that. Amen. But it said Ananias went his way and entered into the house. Ananias could have easily said, phooey on this thing. I'm done. This is it. This is the craziest thing God's had me do. He wants me to go talk to a murderer. He wants me to go and I've served God. I've done everything for God. Tell me if this don't sound like you and I. I've done so much. I've studied my Bible every day this week. I've went to church. I ain't missed a service in 3 months. I've done this and I've done that. And I've cleaned up my mouth. Amen. I've quit telling dirty jokes. Amen. I've quit talking to the wrong people. Amen. I've quit associating with the wrong folks. I've done all this and here's God coming asking me to do something else. I'm done with this. Amen. Have we not been there before?
Amen.
Amen. Have we not been there before? Amen. Amen. He could have easily said, hey, I'm going to my house. I'm going to go sit at my house and be done. Amen. Be done. Amen. Be done. Amen. But no. It said in verse 17, Ananias went his way. He didn't, that doesn't mean he went his, that wasn't a literal, he went the way he would normally go. Amen. No, he went the way God had for him to go.
Amen.
Amen. He went his way. Amen. Amen. Went in and put his hands on Saul. Amen. Put his hands on Saul. And as they say, the rest is history.
Amen.
The rest right there. Amen. The rest is right there. Can I tell you this? Verse number 10, it's inevitable. It's coming to you. God's going to come to you. Amen. And say, hey, I want you to do this for me. Hey, I want you to do this. Hey, I want you to do this. And it might come after you've done everything else. Amen. But God's going to come to you. Amen. He's going to have you do something. Amen. It's going to be a little scary. Amen. It might be a little frightening. Amen. Amen. You might have a little lack of faith and say, I don't know if I know how to do it. Amen. But can I tell you, verse 10 is coming. Amen. But verse 17. Verse 17, where it said Ananias went his way, that's up to you and I. That's up to you and I. That's up to you and I. You might reason everything out with the Lord. You might say, God, here's this. Here's this logical reasoning here. Logical reasoning, amen. I like it when God throws logical reasoning out the window. Amen. Say, preacher, what do you mean? You go over and read about Lazarus, John chapter number 11, when Lazarus was dead. Amen. I heard Brother Doug Benton, and some of y'all might know him. I heard him preach a message one time on when God doesn't make sense. Logical reasoning. Go out the window. Amen. God waited. God waited. Lazarus laid in the grave. Amen. God waited. Amen. Anyway, logical reasoning goes out the window. Amen. Amen. Sometimes in your life, you're going to say, God, this doesn't make sense. I don't know what to do. Amen. I don't know what to do. But verse 10's coming where he's going to say, hey, it's time for you to go. Amen. Verse 17, whether or not you go on your way, whether or not you go the way God would have you to go, whether or not you obey God. Amen. Not obey the preacher. Not obey the teacher. Not obey your friends. Not don't get me wrong. Amen. You ought to obey your parents, but not in this regard. Not obey your parents just because mom and daddy said to do it. Amen. Whether or not you obey God, it's up to you. Amen. Ask everyone to stand. Miss Carolyn, come to the piano. God gave me this message for somebody this morning. Amen. I don't know if you haven't, and you might be there. God might have came to you this morning with verse number 10. Amen. You might have said, I can't do it. I can't do it. Amen. Notice God, let me tell you, God's already prepared everything for it. Amen. God ain't left you hanging, friend. Amen. You ain't gonna get right in the middle of it and God leave you out hanging, friend. God knows what He's doing. Amen. Amen. There's times I don't know what I'm doing. Amen. There's times you don't know what you're doing. Amen. God knows what He's doing. Amen. Amen. When God comes, if God has knocked on your heart's door, amen. If God has asked you for anything, amen, answer Him. The Bible says over there in Revelation, said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. Amen. We use that oftentimes for salvation and talking about Him knocking for salvation. But friend, there's going to be times in your life He's going to knock and say, I need you to go somewhere. I need you to do something. Not everybody's going to understand it. Not everybody, it ain't going to make sense to everybody. It ain't going to be popular. But it's going to be right. I've got big plans. I've got big plans. Amen. If God has spoke with you this morning, come.